Hey there, YouTube, and what is going on? This is the Purple 175, and welcome to another commentary. And this commentary is going to be about why everyone hates you in free for all. It's very simple. It boils down to this. I was in a game, this guy, thinking that, okay, like Chuck Norris, you know how, like, in all of his movies, really cheesy, he runs around with like two light machine guns, just like spraying but hitting people like miles away and stuff. That's what that guy thought he was, because what he would do is he would drop shot every damn kill he got. Alright, so what this video is me drop shotting as many kills as I could to make a point. Alright, drop shotting is a pub stomping thing that you do. You do it against public matched people. Because in that area of people, they're not all as good as people in like league play or like MLG and stuff. So they don't see it coming, so it literally just throws them off and gives you a guaranteed kill pretty much every time. So what I'm trying to say is, don't drop shot every kill, because it's so easy to shoot someone who drop shots if you like are just a above average player, and just, you know, like, you just follow them, like, you shoot where they are. The whole point of drop shotting is to make yourself a moving target when you're stationary, alright? Because when you're a stationary, non-moving target, you're way easier to kill. That's why, like, stun grenades, alright, I know stun grenades are overpowered in this game, but, like, normal stun grenades, like, before, they were so freaking overpowered. Like, the whole fact that it makes you so you can't move as much, that's why they're so, like, that's why they do what they do, because they know how important movement is while you're in gunfights. So that's their purpose. So when you're drop shotting, it makes you a moving target even when you're stationary. That's the whole, like, good thing about it. You only should be doing that when you need to and when you're losing a fight. It's just to throw your opponent off guard and stuff. Like, that's all it is. It doesn't make your bullets do more damage. If anything, since you're dropping, like, you're probably going to start hitting them in the legs, so technically you're doing a little bit less damage, but anyway, that doesn't really matter. There's ways for those people who think they need to drop shot every kill. There's, like, you don't need to do that. You, when you go into a public match and you drop shot and jump around every corner, you're gonna kill majority of the people, because majority of people aren't gonna see it coming, because that's just the kind of players that are in public matches. You go, all right, if the guy that was doing this is watching my gameplay, or just anyone who does this, I'm not trying to, like, call you out and say that you're bad or anything. I'm just trying to let you know that you might need to work on just overall being a better player instead of just drop-shotting all the time, because, like, it doesn't do anything. So, like, what I challenge you to do is I want you to go into some type of competitive game or, like, league play against actual good people, or, like, an MLG game, like game battles, that type of thing. And if you go into that lobby and just try to drop shot every kill, I guarantee you'll still get killed every time. Like, obvious, okay, like, it's not like they're just automatically going to kill you because you drop shot. I'm saying it's going to be 50% less effective easily. Just because of it's the type of people you play against. That's why people just call you, like, a tryhard in lobbies and stuff if you're drop shotting and stuff, because it just beats them and they don't know what to do. I mean, I don't know. I don't really know how to explain it. But I basically got my point across on what I was trying to say, so I'm not going to keep talking about that because there's not much more to talk about. But the last minute of this commentary, I want to ask you guys. I was thinking about doing a series called Weird Challenges. I've already talked about this in other videos of, like, giving me video ideas for you guys, but this is, like, an actual series that I kind of want to do. It's where you guys just challenge me really random things. Like, it can be literally anything, but, like, also think about it. It has to be doable. Like, I got challenged to win a free-for-all doing only headshots. I'm almost 100% positive that's impossible. Like, not impossible. That would be, I don't think anyone be able to do that. But I'm talking about stuff like, I saw a video on YouTube of this guy who, he was challenged to kill himself with a hunter killer drone and an enemy, but you couldn't just throw it at the ground or a wall, so he had to, like, let it fly around the map and try to find who it was gonna kill and, like, get himself killed and that person. So kind of stuff like that. Please leave a comment, like the video if you liked it, dislike it if you like it, tell me what I can prove. I'm all about positive criticism. constructive criticism, that's what it is. So yeah, I really hope you guys enjoyed this commentary. This has been the Purple 175, and I will see you sexy bitches later with some weird funky challenges. Light up that comment box, brah. Alright, see ya.